together for one fall, making his way to the ring, being accompanied by Ric Flair from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 272 pounds, Cripple H.
And the kids of that look the fact that Ric Flair will be at ringside here in this matchup, and I am assuming that Flair will also be at ringside this Sunday at Armageddon, our big pay-per-view spectacular. And I'll tell you what, that whole lineup is coming together unbelievably. We've heard some huge matchups with serious championship implications announced here tonight, but none bigger, King, than the battle for the World Heavyweight Championship.
And two out of three falls, JR. That is what it's all about. And if you ask me, all of those, that stipulation, all three of those falls are in Shawn Michaels' favor. Triple H can't be happy about that.
Well, the game again, without a doubt, the number one contender for the World Heavyweight title. And I can recall when Triple H had another huge showdown with a world-class athlete by the name of Stone Cold Steve Austin. Two out of three falls. Austin won the first fall, and Triple H won the last two falls. I don't think that's ever happened to Austin in his life.
That was it. That was possibly Triple H's greatest match, and I think he needs to duplicate that this coming Sunday at Armageddon.
Well, the game always rises to the occasion in these big match atmosphere, and there's nothing going to be bigger than Armageddon.
North Carolina, weighing in at 218 pounds, Jeff Hardy.
Here's a kid that, well, somehow he manages to rise to the occasion when the match is big, JR.
There's no doubt about that. There's no doubt about Jeff Hardy. As a matter of fact, he does hold a one-on-one victory over Triple H, competing for the Intercontinental Championship back in April of 01.
Does he know I'm an artist? Maybe he ought to check with me and let me do a little body painting on him before the match. He may be a great wrestler, but I don't know about his painting ability.
Well, he is an artist of some renown, but in Triple H, oh, Jeff Hardy acknowledging his fame here in Knoxville. Unfortunately, to do that, he turned his back on the number one contender.
Don't ever,
heavyweight title.
Don't ever turn your back on Triple H.
And again, I'm sorry, Dan.
Well, I'm just going to say that's not how you play the game.
Whoa! A jawbreaker by Jeff Hardy on the game, and you got to wonder here if the game is going to try to set an example for Shawn Michaels to see on young Jeff Hardy, or is Triple H going to be thinking so much about Shawn Michaels that he gets upset here?
Well, if he's trying to set an example right now, the game's not doing too good a job of it.
Could be over right here, the leg dropping. Triple H powering out.
Look at that look on Nature's face. He can't believe what's happening right now.
Oh, hard knocked down by the game. Big, powerful. He's smart. He's got a black heart. There's no doubt about it. And he's obsessed with becoming the world's heavyweight champion. And Eric Bischoff said earlier tonight that the end is near. And when you think about the end being near at Armageddon, it's somewhat ironic to put it in that same sentence, but the end is near for whom?
Well, do you think Eric Bischoff really cares? Do you think he cares which one of these guys destroy each other?
Probably not, quite frankly. Jeff Hardy trying to fight back. Oh, man, Hardy's shoulder.
Now the end is near for Jeff Hardy.
Wow. I'll tell you what, some of the greatest encounters I've ever witnessed, privileged to be a part of, was matchups involving Shawn Michaels and Triple H. You think back to SummerSlam, Shawn Michaels' career was allegedly over. Wasn't he supposed to wrestle? Well, he didn't wrestle. He was in a street fight right down the game's alley, and Shawn Michaels won that match in August at SummerSlam.
Yeah, and don't forget I like to call it the Miracle on 34th Street at Madison Square Garden. Tell them what happened there, Jerry. You remember that?
And then the Survivor Series, it was Shawn Michaels winning the world title against Triple H in the Elimination Chamber. And is this what we're going to see this Sunday at Armageddon? Are we going to see Triple H completely dominate Shawn Michaels in this two out of three fall match?
Well, I can tell you this, whatever we see, it's going to be a classic, JR. But you know, you heard Shawn Michaels say earlier,
spinebuster slam, the hook, and Jeff Hardy kicks.
I mean, this is what you expect any time you go in the ring with the game. You expect to take, well, you're going to take an ass kicking for a while. But eventually, as Shawn Michaels said, this man has a habit of getting full of himself. He gets overconfident, and then he makes a mistake.
He has a hell of an ego. There's no doubt about that. Triple H believes that this business revolves around him. He's a 6'4", 260-pound instrument of destruction.
Right. That's why he's got a huge ego. Wouldn't you have a huge ego if you looked like Triple H? Let me ask you this, Darryl. What do you picture when you look at yourself in the mirror? You picture yourself with a body like...
What the hell do you care?
You picture yourself with a body like Triple H?
What does that have to do with Armageddon on Sunday?
What are you talking about the man's ego?
Well, so he's got a big ego.
I didn't say he wasn't a great athlete.
You got a big ego, too.
Well, so what? And you don't, Superman?
You got a big hat, big ego?
Don't get upset. What's wrong with having a big ego? Just ask Triple H.
Triple H, that overhead backbreaker, showing all that power and strength. The first fall at Armageddon, folks, will be a street fight. The second fall, a cage. And the third fall, if necessary, will be a ladder match. Shawn Michaels in the game on Sunday, and little Jeff Hardy here. He's fighting for everything he's got.
Has Triple H made that mistake that Shawn Michaels was talking about?
Not yet, but it may be coming. Jeff Hardy, oh, and maybe not. And the pedigree. Jeff Hardy tried to counter. He tried to use his quickness and his high-flying abilities and now, got around it.
Why is Triple H not going ahead and pinning? Why is he not going for the cover?
I don't know.
It's that ego. It's got the best of him.
It may be the fact that one pedigree is enough for any human being, and two is cruel and unusual punishment. The second pedigree, Blair's getting a laugh out of it. There's nothing funny about this.
Well, that's what the game is all about. Cruel and unusual punishment.
Uh-oh. And now, wait a minute, now what? Jeff Hardy, after two pedigrees, thrown outside the ring like he was a piece of garbage, and he's not. He's a great young competitor. And now look at Flair.
He's a human being, isn't he, JR?
You're damn right he's a human being. And this is not right.
Well, he shouldn't be like a government mule.
What's funny about that? Two men on one. There's nothing funny about that. And I think Triple H sees Shawn Michaels and young Jeff Hardy here. This is sending a loud message to Shawn Michaels or anybody else.
The message is the end is near. Look at Nate. Nate's opening up.
I think the end has arrived, and then what is Triple H doing?
Well, the end of Jeff Hardy has arrived, but wait a minute.
Now, the Triple H's arm with a steel folding chair,
maybe.
And I don't think he's going to take a seat.
Maybe the end of Jeff Hardy.
Hey, there's a world champion. There's Shawn Michaels. Michaels getting the game's attention here. Oh, this could be some big-time fireworks right here and now, King. Are we going to see any physicality between Michaels and Triple H?
Oh, the end is near, all right, but for who, JR?
This portion of the show is brought to you by VTech. Log on to Canada.com.